get the key. You can give a donation and get the key. You can set it up.
Huh?
Can you set it up or you go to the
party? Yeah, because the ladies need to come.
Yeah. For some time.
Yes.
Usually you
like to yes, yes. But you decide that it's super. You're the boss.
Platform now.
Sit.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Krishna, 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 Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Now, Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Now up. Krishna, down. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Not just Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. 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 Gopi Jana Lalanda Girivar Dhamri. Jaya Gopi Jana Lalanda Girivar Dhamri. Yasoda Nandana Vraja Nandanandana. Yasoda Nandana Vraja Nandanandana. Yamuna Kira Yamuna Tira Vanchari. Yamuna Tira Vanchari. Jaya Shri Krishna Chai Tanya Nityananda Shri Advaita Radha Shri Vasani Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Yeah.
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna Jaya Vrindava Jaya Radhe Jaya Krishna Jaya Vrindava Shri Govinda Gopinatha Madana Mohatha Shri Govinda Gopinatha Madana Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Krishna, 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 Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama. Krishna, 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 Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
Hare.
जय हरि नाम संकीर्तन यज्ञ की जय श्री श्री राधे श्याम सुंदर की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय हरे कृष्ण You can't beat her. Oh, I don't know what it is. Okay. Put. Oi. Now, 1 second. I just have to stretch my legs for 1 minute. A little yoga, dear devotees. Yeah. Touch the toes. Oh. Yeah. Krishna. Okay. Not so hot, no? The easiest way to do this is just to pass it on. So... Okay. Take, little. Zadi? Okay. Now you give to your neighbor and then. No. Give him. He will take it. Now he will do the same. And in this way it can go around. So here in Rawa, we are in the appearance place of Shrimati Radharani. Shrimati Radharani, the feminine, compassionate, soft-hearted counterpart of Krishna, who is always eager to bring any devotee to Krishna. So we're praying here. This is a place for prayer. This is a place where we... This is a place where we go for some mercy. Usually, when I come with a little smaller group, then we sit on the other side. On the other side, there is a tree, or rather two trees, which have grown together. Radha and Krishna are there in tree form. It is said that the deities of this temple were found under that tree. And these deities would then be self-manifest deities. Vrindavan is full of transcendental manifestations. We cannot understand. All that we know is that Om Jnanati Manandasya Kinandana Salakya Shakshuran Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. That through the disciplic succession, Srila Prabhupada presented the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to the world. And we find that as Krishna moved to various places, we were discussing the other day how Krishna moved from Gokul, which is not far from here, because at the time there were so many problems with so many demons. So Upananda, the elder brother of Nanda Maharaj, sort of expressed the need to go. And since he was the elder, everyone could see the point. So then Krishna moved, and we discussed how Krishna moved. But of course, at that time, Radharani's family also moved. And they moved away from here. And so later, Krishna stayed in Vrindavan, then went to Nandagram. And of course, then Srimati Radharani stayed in Varsana. So wherever, naturally, wherever there is Krishna, there is also Srimati Radharani. Srila Prabhupada had that very transcendental vision. One time, the question was raised in 1975 about the name of the deities in the Delhi temple. It is found in Hari Sori's diary. And said, like, how is it possible that the deities are called Radha Partasarthi? Partasarthi means the chariot driver. Is Krishna, who acts as the chariot driver of Arjuna. This is, what has Radharani got to do with this? So this Radharas Bihari, or is this Radha Partasarthi? Wrong name, they said. But Prabhupada said, no. He said, wherever Krishna is, Radharani is always there, even in Kurukshetra. Yeah, we cannot see, we cannot imagine. So Radha and Krishna, it is described, are one. There is one book of Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur entitled the Prema Samputta. And this Prema Samputta is nice. It's a nice story of Radharani and her Sakhi friends were at the time residing in Yavat. Yavat is the place where Radharani resided after her marriage. Rupa Goswami writes in his play, and Purnamasi is speaking, that this was the worst arrangement ever made on this planet. You know, no worse marriage arrangement was ever made than the marriage between Abhimanyu and Radharani. It was the grandmother of Radharani, Mukkara. She did it. Yes, everyone was saying this Mukkara, you know, she's like, yeah, old age must play its part. How is it possible? Anyhow, when Radharani resided there in Yavat, it is an especially intense place in terms of separation. Because there, she's locked up in the house of her in-laws, who are constantly watching and suspecting. And there's two, Jyotila and Kotila. Kotila is described in the Nectar of Devotion. I did bring the book, and I'm, oh. Just put these things back in. And we're going to look for Kotila. One moment, there is in the back. There is an index. Oop, I. Hey, watch out. It's going to do it again. I, Kaelin. I'm very sensitive to this. It can kill me. It's like, it's too much. Feedback of microphones is intolerable. Kriya Krishna. No, that's not there. No, K-O. Ah, K-R, K-I, K-I, K-N, N-O. It should be next. Then comes Krishna. No, it's not there. Okay, then I can't find it without. But it's okay. I'll do it from the memory. So it is said that Krishna is so attractive that all the ladies of Vrindavan are attracted to Krishna, except for Kotila, who has a belly like a pot and breasts like string beans. And therefore it is said, because of her, this is Nectar of Devotion, and because of her extreme beauty, therefore she is not attracted to Krishna. If I would have read it, you would have believed it. Now you're probably thinking that I'm exaggerating, but I'm not. It is exactly like that. A belly like a pot and the string bean breast and her extraordinary beauty. Therefore, yes, he's not attracted to Krishna. Anyway, so we can appreciate how much Kotila and Jyotila are taking turns in guarding Radharani. So she's basically under 24-hour supervision. But there are these moments. No Jyotila. No Kotila. Just Radharani and various of her associates. But Kundalata was there, and somehow or other Jyotila had trusted Kundalata, that Kundalata would make sure that nothing would happen. Yes, definitely, I promise it. And then something came about, that suddenly this very beautiful female in very opulent dress, looking very aristocratic, appeared in the courtyard of Srimati Radharani's residence. That wonderful personality had to be a goddess. No one on earth could ever look like her. She sat down in the courtyard. But instead of being happy and sort of coming to greet, she just sat there, looking down. Radharani sent someone. She sensed something is not right. She sent someone to check. And they came back and said, she's not responding. Then Radharani personally went and said, my dear goddess, I know you must have experienced some great difficulty. I know you are experiencing great sadness, but I must tell you one thing. It will help you greatly if you reveal your heart. We are young ladies like you. We can understand your grief. So if you share your grief, you will feel lighter in your heart. So please, please speak and tell us the cause of this sadness. Then the goddess said, no, no, I cannot speak. Please, 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 you can trust us. Then the goddess spoke and said, you know, I am from the celestial regions. And you know, we are witnessing all your pastimes. Yes, we are witnessing all your pastimes. And she said, I cannot tolerate it any longer. I cannot tolerate it any longer, the way he treats you. It's just too much. It's just too much, the way he treats you. I can no longer bear it. It is too much. And Radharani said, no, no, it's not like that. She said, no, you know, we... No, you can't hide anything from us. We demigods, we're witnessing everything. Yes. She said, you have given everything, everything, all your heart, 100%, everything you have given to Krishna, your entire being, in him, the debauchee. The faithless wretch. How could he cheat you? Yes. Radharani says, no. She said, the relationship between Krishna and myself, right, is the relationship of the deepest love. I am always thinking of Krishna, and he is always thinking of me. Then the goddess said, my dear Radharani, I understand that you would like to believe that. I understand that you would like to believe that. But it really doesn't look like it. Oh, no, it doesn't. No, I will not believe it. I will not believe it. No, Srimati Radharani said, no. There is no difference between Krishna and myself because we are one in thought. We are always one in thought. The goddess said, I can't believe it. Said, but all right, I will believe it. I will believe it. If you close your eyes and in deep meditation, think about Krishna. Right? And in that way, make him appear in this place. Then I will believe it. And Radharani, she closed her eyes and in deep meditation thought of Krishna. And when she opened her eyes, Krishna was there. And then Radharani said, where did that goddess go? And Krishna said, oh, she had to leave. In this way, the pastimes of Radha and Krishna are taking place. And stolen moments, stolen moments, parikyaras. No ring on the finger, no paper, merit certificate, no. Nothing. Parikya. In parikyaras, in this paramour relationship, nothing can be taken for granted. Every moment again, you have to conquer. Every moment again, you have to conquer. This is the relationship between Radha and Krishna. Now, this is not only the relationship between Radha and Krishna. This is the relationship between Krishna and his devotees. Every moment, again, we have to conquer Krishna. We can never think, I did so much service. I even got a medal for it. Yes. Yes, and a golden watch. I did so much service. The Vaishnavas all glorify me. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Still, we have to conquer Krishna again. Every moment. Every moment. So this spirit of conquering Krishna is the essence of Parakiras. This Parakiras means that each time again, by service, each time again, by loving service, by deep love and making a great sacrifice, somehow or other, one has to conquer the heart. Yeah, you know, it's like, okay, you know, I love you. Okay, very nice. I mean, you've been loving me for a long time now. You know, gets a little boring. You know, anything else? You know, what you gonna do? What you gonna do to make me love you? That is spiritual life. That is spiritual life. What will we do to make Krishna, to awaken Krishna's love? That's what it's about. How can we awaken Krishna's love? This is the spirit of Parakiras. This is the spirit of this place. This is the mood of Srimati Radharani. This is the essence. How can we awaken Krishna's love? Yes, of course. Krishna's love is unconditional. Yes, of course. Krishna's love is all-embracing. There is not one living being who is neglected, even the envious one. Krishna even loves the snakes. Yes, even the snakes, he loves them. Even Kaliya got the mercy. Even he got the mercy. Extremely nasty snake. Probably the most serious snake Vrindavan's ever seen. But Kaliya got the mercy. So Krishna's love, in that sense, no one is excluded. But we're not talking about that. We're not talking about that. We're talking about if you want to capture Krishna and say, Mamata, he is mine. Then you'll have to conquer. Otherwise, no chance. No chance. Yes, and we can go on automatic pilot and daily chant around. We can go on automatic pilot and be around for many years. We can wear the neck beads. We can put the tulsi. We can buy the stamps in Vrindavan. Put one here, put one there. Yeah. Very good. But we have to conquer. We have to conquer Krishna. So, if you want to conquer someone, how to do that? Service, okay. Service. You're getting warm, but not hot yet. If you want to conquer someone, how to do that? Loving service. Gets a little warmer, but still. I am hearing, but not hearing. Remember, because you have to give everything. Gets better. Pleasing his devotees, okay. Feed him.
You have to know Krishna.
I have to know Krishna, now you're talking. No, this is better, one step better. What does he like? If I want to conquer you, I have to know what you like. If I know what you like, and I bring that, you go, wow. Okay, that of course is something. But the point is, so in conquering Krishna, the devotee has to become a kinkar, has to become a personal attendant. There is general service, dasya. There is dasya, the general service attitude, and there is kinka. That is, kinka means personal attendant, that we are exactly trying to understand what is the desire of the one who I try to serve. What is his need? In Chaitanya Charitamrita, we find a description of the servant of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whose name was Govinda. And Govinda is described as being so expert in knowing what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted, and he was just reading the signs, right? Facial expressions, a movement, or just seeing, he turned his head, clear. Then already he understood. Because he was so focused on Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, on his desires, and on trying to just meditate on what he wanted. And in that way he served Kinkar. This spirit of serving in this mood of personal attendant, that is Srimati Radharani. She is serving in this way, completely focused on just what is the right thing now for the right for this moment. From moment to moment. That spirit, of course, filters through Vrindavan. Everyone calls Radhe, Radhe. So we see in the winter, we see the deities, even the pictures. All the deities in Vrindavan in the winter get warm socks. And even the pictures get half covered in wool. Right? Bottom, they have like little sweater, you know, for the pictures. Because Krishna is a person, and he has desires, he has needs according to time, place, and circumstance. And therefore, we serve him according to the need, according to the time. Like in the Banki Bihari temple, what they have in the summer, right? They have in the middle of the temple, they have a water pipe that's coming down and a shower head, which is upside down and it's sort of like spraying in all directions. And you're looking at it like, what's this? They're kind of like, you know, they made a shower in the temple, right? What on earth is going on? I wonder, right? Anyone from Australia? Yeah, just wonder what's going on, mate. Got the shower right in the middle of the temple. Somebody okay here? Yeah. Why? Because it's hot. So they make the entire temple cool by splashing water all over the temple. Doesn't matter that if anybody gets wet, that's okay. Because Krishna has a nice cool temple. That's the reason why there's the shower, you see. It is kinkar. It is that mood of serving Krishna according to his need, according to the time, according to the place, according to the circumstance. And the more, the more we become sensitive, the more we can conquer. Conquering is not easy. Yes. Those are the rules of love. You'll have to conquer. That's Swakya is the marriage relationship. There, you're obliged. Duty. Heavy duty. It's like duty, duty. Yes. There is some heaviness about the word kartavya, the word duty. Many people don't like that word, duty. It's your duty. Duty. We will rebel. I have to be careful making faces because one time I did put my hands in my ears and I made a face like that. Then they took a picture and they made it 2 by 2, 2 meters by 2 meters. They blew it up on the wall. That was mean. Whoever did that, that wasn't fair. because it had a Krishna conscious purport. So if we want to conquer, right? Yes, we must know what a person likes. What else we have to do if we want to conquer? Huh? Huh? Attract him how?
Do the things that he likes.
Okay, do the thing he likes. Yeah, I do what you like. What?
Listen to him.
Strong desire to serve him. Strong desire to serve him. Starts getting warmer. Strong desire to serve. You got to go out of your way. You got to, if you want to conquer, you got to go out of your way. Yeah? Yeah. Okay, you want to be a devotee? You want to join the Hare Krishna movement? Welcome. You want to be initiated? Yes, yes, no problem. You got recommendation, you got disciple course, you got everything. Yes? Okay, very good. Where is your stamp on your forehead? Tilak, huh? Anyway, you have all these things. Good, you're approved. Fine. Now you are initiated. How good? Is it good enough to conquer Krishna? Is it still enough? Is it good enough to conquer Krishna? No, no, no. Then what more? Second initiation. Then you have your second initiation. And you chant, you know, different Gayatris. Like, you know, some very deep meditations in these Gayatris. Even about Radharani. Yeah. Is that enough?
No.
Then?
Sannyas.
Take sannyas. Are you sure? No, even sannyas is not good enough. Okay. Propagate his name and fame. Take care of the dislikes. What does that mean?
What that person does not like.
You must take care of that as well, huh? That's very deep. Yes. Keep on surprising. Serve whom he loves. Do something extraordinary. I agree with you.
Bring others to him.
Bring others to him. Anyway, we're all trying. We're all trying. And there's someone else. Yes. Loud!
What?
Huh? I have to make friends with his dog. No, Srila Prabhupada did say that. He quoted actually Srila Prabhupada, so I cannot argue with that. Gotta make friends with Krishna's dog. Say it again. Keep serving, even if you're blamed. Never give up. Yes, that is good. That is good. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Yes, we go through so much, and people may not always appreciate, but don't give up. Yes. So endurance, all these things you have all said are obviously part of conquering Krishna. And there's more, obviously. There's a lot more that we haven't said. There's a lot more than we know. There's more than I know. And there's more for us to find out. That is our business. That you have to do. Dig in the scriptures. Dig for the jewels in the minds of the scriptures that will tell you how to conquer Krishna. But make it the goal of your life to conquer Krishna. Don't try to conquer someone else. Don't waste your time with these things. Conquer Krishna. Of course, Srimati Radharani, she dresses to kill. Yeah? Oh, yes, and on purpose. Oh, yes. There's in the Govinda Lilamrita this extensive description of this tilak. It's not just a dot. It is in the shape of a dot, but my God, they worked on it. All her assistants worked on it for hours. I mean, when Krishna sees that dot, just alone, that alone, and everything. Huh? As the gopis assist Srimati Radharani in dressing, we find a description about Srinivas Acharya. And Srinivas Acharya was in this world and at the same time in the spiritual world. He was a Parisat devotee of the Lord. So it is said that Srinivas one day saw how a pearl nose ring of Srimati Radharani just fell into the Yamuna. Srinivas, he was in this world amongst us. Srinivas, he froze. Meanwhile, in her gopi form, Srinivas dived into the Yamuna, found that pearl nose ring, and presented it just in time, just when it was the moment to put it in. Now that's to be attentive to, you know. So anyway, we are here to learn how to conquer Krishna. That's what it's about. It's not enough to be a member. Have you card? Member card? Huh? You have card? No. Sorry. No entry. Must have card. Credit card. You will give big donation? Yes. Mercy will come. No. Not enough. Not enough. Krishna is not for sale. So to conquer Krishna is going to take a very great effort. It is going to take great intelligence. It's not stereotype. It means something special. It means you have to give it everything you have. Everything. If you hold back a little bit, yeah. Not impressed. That's she is the emblem of that, you know, of just not how every fiber of her existence, of her energy is dedicated to Krishna. So here, of course, we are only praying, we're meditating. And in our meditation, there is sankalpa. And sankalpa is we fix our mind on the goal. So the goal is to conquer Krishna. That's what we get from here. Don't forget, this is a lifetime instruction. So many people say, please give me an instruction. Well, here you got it. Can't give you any better instruction than this. My God. And every day people come to me, can you please give me an instruction? Can you give me an instruction? Give me an instruction, Maharaj, please give instruction. Gosh, you know, I get an obstruction from all these all these instructions. But I'm telling you today, this is the best instruction of all. Really. This is what it's about, you know? Yeah, this is what you're supposed to do. Go conquer Krishna. I know. I also feel like that. I feel exactly like you. I also sit here like, how to do that? But this is really our sankalpa. This is where we fix our mind. This is what we joined for. This is what we did it. I shaved up. When men shave up, you know, it's a big thing, you know, for us, right? Because when once you shaved up, you join and you shave up, it's like I had super blonde, white hair, ultra white. They would call me the white one, you know, like white. The white guy, you know, in the football team, on the football field, that white guy, you know. Not skin, hair, super white hair. Yeah, and then I shaved up and sacrificed it. It was long also because those were the days. So it was a big sacrifice because we had sworn to never go to a barber again. Once the Beatles came to Amsterdam, right, I was 12, old enough, right? And when they came to Amsterdam, I tell you, no self-respecting boy ever went to the barbers again. Barbers went bankrupt overnight. That was it. And my hair grew long and white, and I liked it. And then, God, so it was a big sacrifice to shave it up. And you really felt, now I'm giving my life to Krishna. Well, it didn't quite work out like that. I didn't quite give my life to Krishna. What can I say? It's not so easy to give our life to Krishna. So we are going to, first of all, trying to conquer. Second of all, we're probably going to fail. But it doesn't mean we're not going to try. I'm going to try and give it our best and then see as far as we get, you know. And then we hope for mercy. That's it. And so we pray. So first we pray for this mood to conquer Krishna. Then we pray for the compassion and mercy of Srimati Radharani. We pray that she'll accept us anyway. Yes, so here we are today in Raval, dear devotees. This is the first day that we are consciously going to make that effort of conquering Krishna. And this is like the entire theme of our parikrama. This is what we're doing here. And this is what we're going to try and do in Vrindavan, and then we'll try and bring it back. We'll bring it back. Those who are not physically in Vrindavan, doesn't matter, because there's also an internal Vrindavan. So just enter into your internal Vrindavan space. It is said, Mathura is a state of consciousness. So this is very significant. So let us then take that mood and so our sankalpa is there, our prayer for mercy is there, and the third thing is, we're looking for blessings, right? These three things. So we're looking for blessings here. So after, we'll go to the other side, there is that tree, right, where they say the deities were found, and where, of course, you know, I mean, yeah. Sometimes my skeptical mind goes, this tree, Maharaj, is 5,000 years old. I go, really? It's hard to separate folklore. So there's a lot of folklore. But above is the acharyas. But that tree is a wonderful manifestation. And clearly, Radha and Krishna manifested in that tree. So this morning we started from the Krishna Balaram Mandir, then we started from the Krishna Balaram tree, that's where you boarded the buses, and now we are at this Radha Krishna tree. So we go there. You can... I myself, I've never been much of a tree hugger, you know. In some ways I'm shy. I kind of feel funny when I hug a tree, right? But when I was in New York, I did it, yes. There was Tompkins Square Park tree, which I decided to hug. And of course, you know my story. I hugged and I prayed, what do I do now? This is Prabhupada's tree, what do I do? So I hugged that tree and then I prayed for the power to preach Krishna consciousness, because that's what Prabhupada did from that tree. I'm finished with my prayer, turn around, and there's a boy standing under the tree and he says, what do I have to do to become a monk like you? That tree in Tompkins Square is a desire tree. If you had any doubts about it, I mean, this is the proof, it's a desire tree. So go there to New York, as long as that tree is still there. Embrace the tree and pray for the power to conquer Krishna. Now we can pray here also at this tree. Shortcut, no difference between this tree and the one in New York. Again, pray there for the power to conquer Krishna. So that will keep us busy for a while. Then we'll slowly make our way back to Vrindavan. As you see, this place wasn't too hot. Wasn't that bad, was it? Was okay. Nobody's fainting. It's all right. Kirtan was a little long for some maybe, but you know, for others it was too short. there are really other good kirtaniers here also. They'll get a chance this week for sure. You know, I mean, I'm already beginning to get hoarse, as you noticed. I wanted to break the ice. Of course, you know. Yeah. At least you picked up on the joke. Yeah. At least someone laughed about my joke. You know. I wanted to break the ice today and sort of connect with all of you. I thank you for taking the austerity to come and I hope that we can utilize this time to create some very deep sanskaras, deep meditations and impressions. Let's make it the goal of our life to conquer Krishna. Not just trying to be a good devotee. That's boring. I'm trying to be a good devotee. That's okay. Krishna goes, nice. I'm trying to be a good god. Oh my good god. Have to conquer Krishna. Life is short, so something to do. Yeah. Well, that's food for thought. Let us go to the tree, and then we will return to Vrindavan. Where is Rasa Parayana? The convenience. All right. I guess the public facilities are not so good here. They're all locked.
So many trees. Closed eyes.
So you have to solve your own problems. I'm sorry, I can't help you. It's God for us all and each for himself, for him or herself. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Jai.
Jai.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.